Hi friends, in this video we are going to talk about how to understand your wife. This is the English version of the old video which I already did. So people who could not watch in Tamil can watch this. Okay, the first problem. So why we are talking this serious? Because after this lockdowns and so many things are happening around the world in the corona periods. In general, there is more time husband and wife spent together. So this result in many more conflicts, and the marital life is somewhat indirectly affected by the coronavirus. So that in worldwide we could see many divorce cases are getting filed and so many things are happening because almost 24 hours people both spend time together, which is when there is no proper match between you two, then definitely it will create a huge problem because every single moment the decision making is happening. If two are two different people, if you have many opposite personality traits, then definitely it will be a hell for you. So how to handle this situation? So that is why I'm going to give you solutions, kind of how I approached every problem when it comes to marital counseling. Okay, the first problem I faced, I remember it happened around 2 years back. One guy came to my consultation. So he's from a foreign country, not from India. So he told he and his wife was living in a foreign country. And suddenly, like, he has a problem with wife always because she is not going to his home in India whenever she visits India alone. So that creates so many problems, so many conflicts, and then slowly it become a very big problem when he don't want to attend his wife's brother marriage, and so it become intensified. So now they are at the verge of divorce. So this is the problem he explained. So in general, if he sees this problem, we will come to a conclusion easily that his wife is not a right person. She is doing some mistakes. So that is why this marriage is falling apart. But I had a different perspective because time science gave us a better perspective in this problem. I felt his wife has nothing wrong in whatever she did. I told him the same thing. Your wife is not a problem. She didn't do anything wrong. But he explained, no, my father and mother are having many issues, many health issues, and they need somebody to care, but she is not doing that. She is stone-hearted person like that, he explained. Even then I told him, no, she is right. She has nothing to do with, so she is not wrong at all, like I told. He was confused, and I explained him step by step. Okay, first point, he told, whenever she visits India, she is not visiting her parents. She is going to her own native only, not to his native. Okay, this showed me like she can travel alone from a foreign country to India. In that case, I expected she may have confidence in her. So, which may be because of her, she may be having leadership quality. That is sun dominant person. Then I asked him, did she have leadership quality? He told, yes, she has leadership quality. Then I told him, so here the problem is because a leadership quality person in general care people. They care everyone. They care many people, not everyone. They care people who they support, who support them, and in response they will care them. You know, there is a difference between sun dominant and moon dominant girl. Okay, sun dominant girl take responsibility, but she do everything. She do hard work, she put hard work and all, but she is limited to certain people who she feel her friends, not the enemies. So she always have this separation, enemies and friends. When it comes to a moon dominant girl, she don't see anybody as enemy. She is very emotional person. She may see enemy as a person, but if you go and talk to her immediately, she will be okay. So she don't mind to talk to enemy or whatever it is, but she can relate to anyone, she can talk to anyone like that. But when it comes to taking responsibility, she will be in a very big trouble, even for her own people. So she cannot do anything. She is a bit of a dependent person. She depend on others to help. Okay, so here this girl is a subdominant person. That is what I assumed after that, because I don't have her chart, so I assumed these things. Then I told him, see, if she's a subdominant person, definitely she cares people. It may not be a problem for her. She can travel to anywhere to care. The distance may not be a matter. She can take any bus or rail. She can go by any vehicle. She go and care people. That may not be an issue. But the problem is, she is not ready to care. She is not ready to accept your instruction. So that is where the problem starts. So first thing is, undominant person want to take their own decision. You cannot force them to take a decision. You have to ask them, because they are the better decision makers. They know what to do, when to do, how to do. So you don't need to instruct somebody who is a undominant person. But we as a male dominant people, we always, if this Indian society is of male dominant society, so we always like to think our wives are fools or some lower level creature. So we need to guide them in every possible way. It is not true, first. And second thing is, she, as a subdominant person, she always have this line. Are you a friend or enemy? That is very, very important. You can relate to it as the politicians. You know, the politicians always have that line. If you are a friend, they will help you. If you are enemy, they will never help you. They want you to destroy you. So like that. So that is the core quality of a subdominant person. So here, I ask him another question, because I doubted she may not consider even her husband as his friend. So that may be the problem. That may be the core problem. I ask him, who is your priority? Will you give priority to your parents or your wife? Then he strongly said, only to my parents. Then only she is. Who is she? She is just my wife, right? So this is another big problem in the Indian society, Indian male mindset. See, we don't know what is family. Even after we get married, your family is all about you, your kid, your wife, your kid. That's it. Your mother, father are not your family, first of all. This education we don't have in mind, because our culture is totally opposite to it. Patriarchal society, which believes in the joint families, and so that we cannot accept this theory. But the problem is, joint family is created for agricultural and many economical purposes. And when a family is doing agriculture, the land cannot be separated. So they want to live together, stay together, so that they can have a profitable business. But nowadays, everything is changed. So there is no that important for a joint family. So we are now, the priority is more about nuclear family only. And always remember, a woman creates a family. One woman, not two women. A family can have only one woman. Two women together, definitely it is a terrible thing. Okay, everybody knows that. So one woman, so what is this? Is your wife is a family, you are part of that family, and your child is a part of a family. Your mother is a separate family, and in your mother's family, there is your father. So you switched from your mother's family to your family. This is the reality. But we think a girl after getting married is changing the family. It is not true. A girl is creating the family. So a guy has to change the family. That is the actual context. That is why every culture and everything is based on women. They only build the family. They only keep the family and the honor, everything on the female thing. So first thing you should realize, your family is only you, your kid and your wife. You should give priority to her. So when you don't give priority to her, she feel insecure. She don't have trust in you. When she don't have trust in you, she feel you as an enemy. She treat you as an enemy. When she treat you as an enemy, she will not do whatever you want. And very important thing is, subdominant people care their family so much, because they care people. They care anybody who support them. When it comes to family, it is very, very tight relationship they want to maintain. So her wife, inside her mind, want to have a tight family. But since his priority is different, she feel insecure about it, and she don't want to join with him. She don't want to accept him as her friend, and she keep him as an enemy. When he himself an enemy, his family is definitely going to be an enemy. She never going to care them, or she never going to go to their place. So how to solve this? So here the solution is, actually, he has to talk to her first. he has to convince her. He never ever in hereafter force her to carry his family or going to his family, visit them and all. So he should not do that. So he should commit her, he will not do that. And let her come back to the country, come back to the foreign country from India, from her native, and promise her you will never force her in anything. Just accept her as your family. And assure her you will she will be given the first priority in anything. First, initially she will not, she cannot understand it because she feels the shock of the change. But after that, slowly she love it. So when she got that priority, when she got that trust back, when she got that love back, after that, she want to listen to you. She want your instruction. She want your advice. She want your guidance and everything. So that moment, she will go to your family without even, you don't need to tell her. You don't need to tell anything. You don't need to force. You don't need to tell. When she visit India, she will definitely go to her home and she will care your family very much. There won't be any problem at all. Now you are destroying her trust and asking her to do favor, which is horrible to do. Because she already feel very insecure about marrying you. And you are forcing her to go to your family and make it more worse, which is not right. And also you are creating a guilt to her by saying your parents are ill and they are having more problems like that. Whenever you try to manipulate her, it won't work. Because she is a son dominant, she has the leadership quality. Okay, she is not just an emotional person who felt guilt and go to that place. It has no use feeling a guilt and helping others. It has to come as out of love. She has so much of love, definitely she will have. But first you have to build a trust, then definitely she will come to you. So hope you get some clarity about this situation. If you have something related to the situation, try to understand this in a right perspective. Okay. If you have any doubts, if you have a questions related to your marriage, in a not specific questions with your birth time and all, any general questions about your married life, you can write it in the comment section or you can send it across in our contact us page. I will try to do a small video over it. I'll try to guide you. Okay. Otherwise, you can take a proper marriage counseling session. Okay. Take care.